join me now with some fairly local residents and half of the members of Breton. This is Dan and Adam. Welcome to the Trailer TV. So guys, I guess the first question, when you talk about Breton, what springs to mind is André Breton, the whole surrealist movement. Yeah. Is that the kind of vibe you're going for? I mean, how important is art to what you guys do?
How important is it? Well, I guess pretty important. Relatively important. I think it is art, isn't it? But you can't really answer that without sounding a bit pretentious. So.
Well, you guys have got a live VJ during your sets normally, haven't you? And is that one specific member of the band who takes on that role, or do you all have a say in what gets projected?
Like, we all film stuff, but yeah, he's in charge of it when it comes to live. He'll just vibe it depending on what's going on. So yeah, he's triggering depending on what the mood is and what's going on. So it's, yeah.
Cool.
It's kind of like a hype man, isn't it?
Hype man. I like it. Vibes man. Vibes man for the aesthetic going on. So a lot of your stuff comes under the Breton Labs label. Can you explain what your lab is? I'm imagining a hive of activity.
We used to have a lab, but we lost the lab. So maybe we're going to change the name. But yeah, it used to be a huge warehouse where we could record and shoot videos and take photographs. But that's recently, we lost that, so we're working on getting somewhere new. So it'll be a Lab Mark 2 for the new album.
Yeah.
So you're going to be DJing this evening. Is that kind of like foreign territory for you, being in a band and all? Or are you guys quite comfortable with the role of DJing?
I think a lot of people are really like familiar with it. Like, electronic artists are really familiar with it when they like just get to it and they do it really well. But it's like been a learning process for us. But no, we've done it. So we've done it a couple of times. So
is it like meticulous planning for you guys of what you're going to play in your sets? Or
yeah. I didn't sleep last night. Just done it.
Dedication.
Dedication to the cause indeed. So I was watching you guys playing Jostle on the Blogotech. There's a French internet channel, and it looked like they crammed all six of you, was it, into this tiny cafe. Have you had fun touring the world and playing cafes, it seems?
It's been amazing. It's been the best year of our lives, no question. That particular one was amazing because we arrived at a place that had never had live performance. So we rocked up with all of our backline from the labs, a PA and all the equipment, and the owner was just freaking out, but yeah, it came together well.
So
it worked out well. It was good.
Cool. So you're now working on a follow-up album to Other People's Problems. How's it going? Is that a dangerous question?
No. It's going swimmingly, yeah. It's coming along, so yeah. You'll have to wait and see, but yeah.
Have you got any dates in mind for when this might be out there?
Like, the start of next year.
Start of next year, okay. Early 2014 then for the next Breton album. So you've had, you've made, I should say, a double-sided vinyl for Record Store Day coming up this Saturday. So you've got Busy P and artwork on the remixes. How did that collaboration sort of come about?
I think Busy P, I think like a friend or our manager knows the Ed Banger guys, the French record label, and I think he was just really keen to get involved. I think I'm not sure about the artwork, though. I'm just glad that he did it.
Big in the game, names added. Let's go. So making something for Record Store Day obviously carries a sort of lot of weight with it. It's still pumping out the physical product and supporting independent record shops. Do you think that vinyl is still important?
Yeah, absolutely. It's a fetish. Still has a place, like definitely. Although we're not spinning any tonight, but it does have a place. So
I think we're going to be watching the video for The Commission this evening. I hear that a guy from Deptford was recruited for the video. Who is he?
I thought he'd be here. He's normally here all the time. But yeah, it's called Pat Lyons, and he's worked on a lot of stuff with us. You know, always in there. Yeah, he's great. He's fantastic. And a guy called Stuart Sinclair did all the CGI and collaborated with us. So it's a pleasure working with both those guys.
Patrick Lyons.
Big up Pat Lyons. Great stuff. So I have to say, what is your favourite track that you're going to be playing in your set this evening?
There's a tune by TCTS called 1997, which is really cool. Or there's a tune by a guy called Amtrak, which is like, this is ridiculous.
So we're going to see you sort of losing your mind slightly by playing it.
Yes.
I think it's quite nice having people on the website dancing while they DJ.
Yeah, yeah, we'll do that. We can do that.
Good stuff. Yeah. So we've got quite a lot of noise going on in the background. This is all good stuff. And we're ready to play everyone The Commission now. This is Breton and The Commission. And if you like it, you should go and buy Other People's Problems.
Force to act. Thanks a lot to Emily for that amazing interview. I'd like to send a big up to Pat Lyons, apparently. Have no idea why, but apparently he's in the video. We've got Ben and Adam from Brenton. Oh, no, sorry, Dan and Adam from Breton. From Breton, because they're going to be DJing right now. No bands. So here's the guys, the Breton guys.
Me. it. This is the Trainer TV, baby. Oh God. Woo! Big up Warshare, big up Xavier. Been a hard time tonight, but it's all paid off.
Thank you. We'll be right back.